Namaste. Good morning. Welcome all of you. So, with the grace of the Divine Mother, we are trying to have a spiritual discussion on Shakti Chatushtaya, the four aspects of the Mother. This discussion will be on the four great aspects of the Mother, Shakti Chatushtaya. As we know, Sri Aurobindo writes, to the four we give the four great names. To the four we give the four great names. Maheshwari, Mahakali, Mahalashmi, Mahasaraswati. So, wisdom, strength, harmony, perfection are their several attributes. So these four great names, four great aspects of the Mother, Maheshwari, Mahakali, Mahalashmi, Mahasaraswati. In brief, we will have a brief glance at the different aspects of the Mother as described by Sri Aurobindo. Tranquil is initial, the first aspect is Maheshwari. Tranquil is she and wonderful, great and calm forever. Tranquil is she and wonderful, great and calm forever. Nothing can move her because all wisdom is in her. She harbors wisdom. Wisdom is the major aspect of Maheshwari. Great and calm forever. She is quite wonderful. Equal, patient and unalterable in her will. Special characteristics she possesses, equal for all. Patient, there is no impatience. Unalterable, she never changes, alters in her wills. But partiality, she has none. Never she shows any partiality for anyone. Partiality, absolutely lacking in her character. To the wise, she gives a greater and more luminous wisdom. To the wise, she gives a greater and more luminous wisdom. Those that have vision, she admits to her counsels. On the hostile, she imposes the consequence of their hostility. The ignorant and foolish, she leads according to their nature. So, he is having a great quality, great aspect. All her to her child, her children, and is the eternal portions of the one. To whom she is the mother, universal mother. All are to her eyes, her children, and portions of the one. Even the Asura and Rakshas and Pichacha, those that are revolted and hostile. So, for they are also her children, as the mother, she takes care of her, and she looks in the with impartial eyes. Even her rejections are only a postponement, her punishments are a grace. So, just imagine this is the power of Mahalashmi as described by Sri Aurobindo. Wonderful, great and calm forever. All wisdom is in her. Equal, patient and unalterable in her will. Partiality she has none. Wise she gives a greater and luminous wisdom. All are equal in her eyes, her children are portions of the one. Even the Asura and Rakshas and Pishas, the ones that are revolted and hostile, they are also her children. Even her rejections are only a postponement. Even her punishments are a grace. So this is the power of Mahalashmi. Second aspect we are seeing, that is Mahakali. Not wisdom, but height. Not wisdom. Wisdom, it is possessed. It is Mahakali possesses wisdom. But here, for Mahakali, it is height. Not wisdom. Wisdom, it is the Mahakali, Maheshwari's province. It is found in Maheshwari's province. Not wisdom, but force and strength are her peculiar power. The peculiar power in her is the force and strength. And height is her speciality. All her divinity lives out in the splendor of tempestuous raksham. Divinity lives out. Entire divinity, it is there. All her divinity lives out in the splendor of tempestuous raksham. She is there for the swiftness, for the immediately effective process. Like this, Mahakali possesses a great value of strength and power. Terrible is her host, no, her face to the Asura, dangerous and ruthless her mood against the haters of the divine. She is a great thing, possesses a great thing. Terrible is her face to the Asura, Asura or demons we see. Terrible is her face to the Asura. Dangerous and ruthless her mood against the haters of the divine. Those who hate the divine, who are the haters of the divine. Terrible and dangerous, dangerous and ruthless her mood. Indifferent, negligence and sloth in the divine works she cannot bear. She smites awake at once with sharp pain if need be, the untimely slumberer and the loiterer. She is severe to the indifference and negligence and sloth in the divine works she can never bear. Her spirit is tameless. It can't be tamed. Her spirit is tameless. Her vision and will are high and far reaching like the flight of an eagle. Just imagine the eagle, the great bird that is flying on the top of the root or at the high, very high height it is flying. So like this, her spirit is tameless. Her vision and will are high and far reaching like the flight of an eagle. For she is the mother and her love is as intense as her wrath. Already know she is a mother. Her love is as intense as her wrath. In her, if her anger to the is dreadful to the hostile, her love is. If her anger is dreadful to the hostile, the vehemence of her pressure is painful to the weak and timid. So she wants to carry out the equal pressure with maybe application of the pressure. She wants to build all the even the timid and the shy and the weak. But for her, what is done in a day might have taken centuries. So, with this swiftness, with her swiftness, she tries to bring the entire the works of the century in a very brief hour, very short period. But for her, what is done in a day, maybe within a day, what would have taken for centuries. To knowledge she grips a conquering might, those possessing knowledge, where there is knowledge. To knowledge she gives a conquering might. Nothing can satisfy her that falls short of the supreme ecstasies and the highest heights. Her labor, her vision, her work is on supreme ecstasies and the highest heights. Nothing short of that, these two is satisfactory to her. Therefore, with her is the victorious force of the divine, because with the force and force and power, she has to reshape the her universe and reshape the world all around. So with this, we'll go for the third aspect, that is Mahalakshmi, who is possess harmony and beauty in measure, in a general form. Mahalakshmi, can Sri Aurobindo speaks of Maheshwari, before he will stress upon the previous two, Maheshwari and Kali, Mahakali. Maheshwari can appear too calm and great and distant for the littleness of earthly nature to approach or contain her. Maheshwari can appear too calm and great and distant, calm and great and distant, too calm and great and distant for the earthly littleness of earthly nature to approach or contain her. But Mahakali, second aspect, Mahakali is too swift and formidable with its weakness to bear or bear, but the Mahalakshmi is different. Joy and longing, all turn to joy and longing, with joy and longing to Mahalakshmi. She is not distant, she is not swift, she is not formidable weak for the weakness as Mahakali, neither she is too great and calm and distant for the as Maheshwari, but actually she is the lover, she possesses the harmony and the beauty. Magnetic is the touch of her hands. Magnetic, about Mahalakshmi, Sri Aurobindo writes, magnetic is the touch of the oneness. And her occult influence refines mind and life and body. Where she presses her feet, course miraculous streams of an entrancing ananda. This ananda and this greatness resides in the with Mahalakshmi. Grace and charm and tenderness flow out from her like light from the sun. And wherever she presses her feet, course miraculous streams of an entrancing ananda. Like sun from the sun, light and heat are coming. From the mother, from Mahalakshmi, it is coming grace and tenderness, grace and charm and tenderness as flowing uninterruptedly into the human arena, into this atmosphere, into this environment. Harmony and beauty. of mind and soul, harmony and beauty of the thoughts and feelings, harmony and beauty in every outward act and movement, harmony and beauty of the life and surroundings. This is the demand of Mahalakshmi. So this entire harmony and beauty between mind and soul, between thoughts and feelings, between every outward act and movement, between life and surroundings, this is the demand of Mahalakshmi. Where love and beauty are not, she possesses, she loves the material of love and beauty. The great aspect of the love and beauty are not or relevant to be born, she does not come. Where there is love and beauty are unfound, they are not present, she never comes. Life is turned in her supreme creations into a rich work of celestial art, and all existence into a poem of sacred delight. Just imagine how Mahalakshmi works. Life is turned into a supreme creations into a rich work of celestial art, and all existence into a poem of sacred delight. Let us move towards the last aspect, what is known as Mahasaraswati. Her Mahasaraswati is the power of Mother's work and the spirit of perfection and order. The fourth aspect possesses perfection and order. The youngest of the four, she is the most skillful in executive aspect. Her work is perfection, order, and executive faculty. She executes. Maheshwari lays down the large lines of the world forces. Mahakali drives their energy and impetus. Mahalakshmi discovers their rhythms and measures. But Mahasaraswati presides over their detail of organization and execution, relation of parts and effective combination of forces, and unfailing exactitude of result and fulfillment. This is Mahasaraswati's province. Always we'll go for another thing. Mahasaraswati, Maheshwari, the difference between other three and this Mahasaraswati, Maheshwari lays down large of the lines of the world forces. Mahakali drives their energy and impetus. Mahalakshmi discovers their rhythms and measures, but Mahasaraswati presides over their detail of organization and execution. And effective combination of forces, and unfailing exactitude of result and fulfillment. The science and craft and technique of things are Mahasaraswati's province. When she takes up the transformation, this transformation, perfection, the organization, execution are the parts of Mahakali. When she takes up the transformation and the new building of the nature, her action is laborious. Nothing is too small or apparently trivial for her attention. Nothing is falls short of a perfect perfection satisfies her. A mother to our wants, a friend in our difficulties, a persistent and tranquil counselor and mentor. So this is the executive faculty, presiding nature of Mahasaraswati. All the work of the other powers leans on her for its completeness, for she brings the completion, she is there to complete it altogether. And we are seeing in couple of languages, for the four to the four, we can consider and we'll take. Sri Mother speaks of, in Sri Aurobindo writes also, indirect terms, I am Durga, goddess of the proud and strong, and Lakshmi, queen of the fair and fortunate. I wear the face of Kali when I kill. This is the mother's indirect voice. I am Durga, goddess of the proud and strong, and Lakshmi, queen of fair and fortunate. I wear the face of Kali when I kill. I am Maya, the universe is my cheat, also it has been described. Anyway, so these four aspects, excluding these four aspects, we have got another also, Sri Aurobindo quotes. There are other great personalities of the Divine Mother, but they were more difficult to bring down and have not stood out in front with so much prominence in the evolution of the Earth consciousness. Because mind has gone up to that moment, we have seen these four great aspects. Thank you.